Hi, everybody. My name is Peter, and I work with electronics. So there's this concept in electronics called processing power, which is basically how quickly can your electronic device go through a series of lines of code to run the software that you want it to run, essentially to do the cool things that you want it to do every day. Now, if you look throughout recent history, in 1985, there was something called the Cray 2 supercomputer. This was the fastest computer on Earth at the time. It was $32 million and about the size of a washing machine. Fast forward to 2011, and you have the iPhone 4. This was $200 with contract and fits in the palm of your hand. Now, the thing I want you to take away from this is that these two things actually have the same processing power, meaning they have the ability to do these same things. So as the size of our electronic devices has gone down to the same amount of power, the cost has gone down tremendously as well. Now, this trend would continue. However, there's a major problem that the general public is kind of unaware of, which is that 90% of the individual components in your electronic devices are made out of the element silicon. However, if you try to get silicon down below about 10 nanometers, your device actually won't work. And there's some very complex solid state physics behind why this is true that I don't have time to go into right now. But if you look at companies like IBM or Intel, they're actually moving away from using the element silicon to want to use new materials instead. So in my lab, we're a little bit ahead of the game, and we use new materials that are 2D, essentially flat, like graphene, to build real working devices that are versatile and flexible for the next coming age of electronics. These materials are about 1 nanometer in height, a tenth of what silicon could ever be. They have better electrical performance and will eventually be cheaper than the silicon counterpart. As an analogy, imagine you're running a business and you need 10 people to do the same job. These guys are generally unproductive, unhappy people. That's your silicon-based model. Instead, now you only need one employee to do that same job. He's 10 times as productive and actually wants to be paid less for some reason. That's your graphene-based model. So you can see the difference here is very significant. We actually have to get over this 10 nanometer barrier if we want to keep making the things that we care about better. Whether it's more efficient solar panels and renewable energy, better technology for helping the third world, the next age of space exploration, or even new biomedical devices like this one on the bottom right, made out of graphene that actually monitors your blood sugar in real time, potentially protecting the lives of the 400 million people across the world that have diabetes, more than the entire population of the United States. So as Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX and Tesla Motors, says, if something is important enough, you do it. And hopefully today I've convinced you that shifting to these new materials is important enough for you to support. Thank you for your time.